Ah!
Hi, we're iDefined, and you're watching The Sleeve.
So iDivide, how important would you say style is to you as a band?
Well, Kristen spends about half an hour in his hair every morning.
Yeah, it's just all about the quiff. It's gone flat, we've just played, but normally he's pretty decent.
Well, you can see now we're not very stylish. I've kind of got into some dirty shorts in a... This is actually a woman's coat, so...
Eclectic and rustic is the look.
I go for the tramp look. My shoes as well, they've got holes in.
You can sell that.
But, yeah, I respect people who are good at dressing.
What would you say your overall style is? Double denim?
Double denim, yeah. But I don't like to mix the whole. I don't like to do blue on blue. You've got to have some sort of...
Contrast.
Yeah, contrast. A bit of juxtaposition there between the top and bottom. So, yeah, this is why we're on stage. So it is a bit sweaty right now, but...
Shall I stand further away? Is it?
Yeah, can you smell us?
I put some Adidas spray on a minute ago.
I could just smell man. Which is all good, isn't it? Now, do you guys say, if you think one of you is looking a bit shoddy, do you say, you're not wearing that on stage, mate, take it off?
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, we'll tell each other off and be like, well, what are you doing? Cab normally wants to wear, like, some tiny little pads or, like... He's the worst, I'll sing
it. Tom is the worst, yeah. It's pretty much the rest of us. We kind of, like, we know what we want to look like. And then there's Tom, who kind of grabs things and puts them on and then kind of like, yeah, guys, I'm going on stage now. We're like...
Just don't.
No. Because he's like the rep of our band, because he's our singer. Everyone looks at him and thinks, oh, that's what iDivide look like. And we're all there, kind of a bit behind him, all dressed nice and smiley, just like, we're here as
Please
well.
Please look at us.
Look how good we look.
Stylists ever try to dress you in anything on photo shoots that you're like, oh, please don't make us wear that?
We're quite easy. We had a photo shoot where we were dressed up as like butchers before, but we don't really care, do we? We're like, we'll do it. It's fine.
Fun and game.
It's fine as long as our name's getting chucked around. We'll do anything.
It's normally our Dave, our drummer, who kind of doesn't want to do it quite as much. He's just a little bit more like, I don't know. Yeah, he thinks everything's affecting his street rap a little bit. So he's. But he's probably the least fashionable one anyway.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
Effortless, is he? The style?
Yeah, or just not bothered.
Lackadaisical.
As much, yeah.
Do you guys have tattoos?
I'm the only one in the band with a tattoo.
Okay, let's see it. Oh. Can we see it? Is it in an exposed...
It's a bit cringy, but it's on my arm. It's lyrics, so it's even more cringy. It says this world won't change for us.
Nice.
It's a nice little saying. Yeah. If it's a saying, I don't know what it is.
Go with that.
I like it. It keeps me going.
And now, why have you chosen not to? Is there a particular reason why you're not into the tattoo thing?
Not particularly. I mean, I'm tempted to get my first tattoo this year at Download Festival, because they always do tattooing free on artists, which, you know, saves me some money. So, no, nothing against it whatsoever, really. Just never... I think I'm really quite picky, and I'm a bit of a perfectionist. I'm probably a bit too sensible for my own good. So it's only now, really, I'm just... I think if I did anything, it'd have to be kind of designed by myself. I can't draw anything, but, I mean, at least a concept in some way, and really be sure on it.
It's a commitment.
Yeah, I guess so, and I'm... You know, so hopefully...
Downloads today.
Yeah. I might get a bit drunk and just do the whole body, face and shit.
You need to watch out for this guy.
The Mike Tyson kind of like bad man.
You reckon that look good on me?
Yeah,
you're definitely a bad man. So I think that is it's the one for you.
Okay, yeah, maybe I'll do that. Most people get the first tattoo on their face, don't they? Is that where you start?
That's the way to do it.
Shoulders, knees, and toes. I've heard that expression be used. So
I can't wait to see this. I'm gonna find you at Download and see what you've done.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, well, you're worried now.
Maybe if I get a tattoo download, you can come along and we can do an interview at the same time.
We should do that. Okay, it's on camera now.
It's on camera. I need to...
Well, a few of us plan on getting tattooed at Download, so it's probably going to happen.
Let's do this. An iDivide tattoo special.
Yeah. Ratings as well, so you can do 10
ratings.
Because we have a competition who's the hardest in the band.
Who cries and...
So, it's winning, so...
Me, probably.
Probably. Well, I'm first, you're second.
Well, this is it. We won't ever back down. I'm the only one with a tattoo.
Says it all, doesn't it?
But Josh is really muscly.
Yeah, tattoo, you're afraid to get out. Oh, Josh, I'm a tattoo.
No, I've started something now, haven't I? Let's go all arty and creative and talk about your album artwork then. So did you kind of have full input on that, or did you give it control to someone else?
Yeah, it was my concept. I came up with really the last CD we brought out. The CD's called What's Worth More, and a lot of the lyrics are to do with sort of more the argument between kind of like happiness and being unwealthy and kind of being unhappy and rich and kind of that kind of argument. A lot of it sort of, and there's a song in the album called What's Worth More. And the idea I kind of wanted to try and show that balance between people being rich and unhappy and poor and unhappier and things like that. So, I mean, the album artwork that we've on our last CD is, it's kind of like, it shows there's an island flowing over the sea, and it shows kind of like kind of monkey looking people, kind of like Buddha kind of looking people on the album, on the island and floating above the sea, kind of dancing around. And then there's people in suits and things kind of swimming to it, like holding on to their money and things like that. So yeah, I quite like the concept. I got someone that I know to draw it up, an illustrator that I met through my brother, and came out really well. But we've got an album coming out in autumn, and we're actually just at the stage now where we're trying to decide what we want. We haven't got a name or album marker yet. We pretty much spent the whole...
We've spent like 2 days so far. We've got a list of album names.
Throw some out now, just in case they end up being the final one, so I can say I've got an exclusive.
I don't think we've homed in on any enough yet. You know what I mean? And most of the ones we come out with are just are stupid suggestions as well.
They really are, though, at the beginning, aren't
they? Yeah. So we've got about 90% of our suggestions are us just messing around, and then probably maybe like three or four in there which are.
There's a few alright ones, but a lot of them are stupid.
Yeah. Well, that's the stupidest one, give me that.
Well, it's just like, it's quite rude.
I'm up for it.
Am I allowed to say? Well,
we're in Outhouse Studios.
Yeah, we're recording our album at Outhouse Studios, and they have magazines everywhere. One of them is a naughty magazine.
Of course it is.
And in the back, I was like flicking through, and we're like shouting out names, and there was one like, just like, Filthy Granny Wants to Get Filled In. So like, I divide Filthy Granny Wants to Get Filled In. Things like that we were going for.
You won't forget that in a hurry, though, would you?
We probably won't go for it.
I'm not sure, yeah. Maybe toss a coin or something, but there's quite a few. There's quite a few in there. Ben Humphreys, who's recording our album, keeps suggesting things with the word sun in it. Things like sunstroke, but maybe not instead of spelling sun like sun, spell it the other way you can spell it. Yeah.
Clever.
Clever, but highly inappropriate. I'm not sure how many more we should say.
We've got more rude ones than we have.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, there's like horrible. Like, these magazines are filthy. And a lot of inspiration in those.
Yeah.
Well, let's end it on a PC note. Okay, your style icon from the music industry, bam.
Say that again.
Style icon from the music industry. Who do you most admire, style?
David Beckham. He's cool.
Very attractive.
Yeah, he's got nice toes, muscly. He's got a nice quiff.
What's going on?
I don't know, really. There's a lot of bands out there at the moment that sort of go through different phases of styling and change from like album to album. I don't know, really. I wouldn't say I really get any influence from anyone in particular. I guess it's kind of, you kind of do your own kind of twist on the maybe a majority kind of style. So a lot of people are going with starting to have things like more denim coming in and so kind of like vests and kind of a bit more rocky style that maybe they had like than they had 5 years ago. But I don't know.
Maybe you guys can start a trend or a style movement.
I need to.
What sort of trends?
I've got a few ideas out there that I want to try out, but they're kind of secrets. So I don't want
to. All secrets here, isn't it, today?
Yeah.
We're sneaky.
This is going to be the new big thing, so.
Track you down at Download and try and get more out of you then. Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot.